our body has three doshas, vata, pitta and kapha. Similarly, our mind has two doshas, rajas and tamas. Rajas can be understood as attraction. Tamas can be understood as darkness or lethargy. Like if you have a class to attend or a movie to watch, if rajas is more in you, you'll get up early, go and watch the movie. If you have more of tamas, you would want to skip the class or movie. Sattva is the supreme quality of mind. If someone is very spiritual, righteous, truthful, he is said to be sattvic in nature. So, being spiritual, righteous, etc. are because of sattva, which is the supreme quality of mind. Mind and knowledge gaining process. Mind connects sense organs with intellect. This helps to passing of knowledge from sense organs to intellect and then to soul. This is how we gain knowledge. Mind cannot be perceived by sense organs. Mind can only be perceived by its actions. Mind's actions are determined by the qualities of soul, like desire, hatred, comfort, misery, intellect and effort. So these are the qualities of soul which determine the action of mind. Though mind has its own actions, its qualities and actions are driven by the qualities of soul. The qualities of soul is decided by karma, spiritual practice, good and bad deeds of this life and yester lives. Mind functions. Chintya, thinking. Vichara, analyzing or elaborating. Uha, guessing, perceiving, assuming, etc. Gaining knowledge by conduction of information gained from sense organs to intellect. Sankalpa, determination or dedication. Vyavicharana, doubt and uncertainty. Cause for disease of mind. In sense organs, if you underutilize any sense organ, like not seeing at all or not hearing at all, or overutilize, like looking at very bright objects, hearing loud music, or misutilize, like looking at sharp objects, hearing to weird music, etc., it causes sense organ disorders. Similarly, underutilization of mind, such as not thinking, less thinking, not reading, not engaging in knowledge, etc., or overutilization of mind, like excessive thinking, excessive guessing, unnecessary analysis, etc., or misutilization of mind, like thinking about unwanted or weird things, etc., these cause imbalance of mind doshas, that is rajas and tamas, and it leads to mental disorders. How to maintain good mental health? We have learned that sattva is the supreme quality of mind. More the sattva means more the mind power and qualities. This also means well-balanced rajas and tamas. Hence, all efforts should be made to improve sattva. This can be achieved by adopting spiritual, noble and righteous lifestyle. A few examples of such a lifestyles are brahmacharya or following abstinence or celibacy, ethical behavior, good control over sense organs, knowing what to see, what not to see, what to read, what not to read, etc. Suppression of undesirable mental qualities, such as suppression of grief, greed, fear, anger, jealousy, excessive desire, ill will, etc. Avoiding arishad vargas, that is lust, anger, greed, delusion, ego and jealousy. Proper amount of sleep, good and nutritious food, avoiding laziness and procrastination, getting up early in the morning, spiritual practices like yoga, pranayama and meditation. So these all empower the mind and help you to maintain good mental health. To learn more, please visit easyayurveda.com.